Last night at Backlash, I did exactly what I said I was going to do. I humiliated Edge. I embarrassed Edge. I wrote the final chapter in his story of redemption. But I also gave him closure. I knew the minute I saw him in January at the Royal Rumble, when he made his miraculous return to the ring, that there was no way in hell he was gonna ever be the competitor that he was back in the day. All he needed to do was let me help him, but he was stubborn. He resisted. All he needed to do was trust me. Just like I trusted him years ago when he saved me from myself. Just like I trusted him years ago when he saved me from my own self-destruction. Now, at WrestleMania, I was not the last man standing. But I stand here today in this ring, victorious after the greatest wrestling match ever. Which makes me the greatest wrestler ever. And I don't need a WWE title to prove it. But what I do need is to thank you, Edge. I need to thank you for reigniting that fire in my gut. That fire that only burns at the expense of other legends. You help me remember what it's like, what it feels like to be the legend killer. And I wish to hell you were here right now so I could thank you man to man, face to face. But you're not here, and I know why you're not here. And it's not only because I punt-kicked you in the skull last night at Backlash, at the greatest wrestling match ever, but it's because I also tore your tricep clean off the bone. Now, I knew right when it happened during our match, and I could have ended it right there, but I had to keep going. You know why? Because I had to make you suffer. Suffer for your own good. Suffer so that I would send you back home to be a husband and a father to Lyric, Ruby, and Beth. I know why you're not here. It's because you are in some godforsaken hospital. On an operating table while a team of doctors try to surgically reattach that muscle to the bone. Seems you have another mountain to climb. And I hope to hell you reach the peak of that mountain. I hear you're going to be cleared in July. July. Of 2029. So hopefully our paths cross once again, say in 9 years.
Twisted perspective from Orton, but guys, this Christian's, yeah, that's Christian, the best friend of Edge. Christian, as we know, was there last night at Backlash.
Not to mention last week here on Raw, Joe, we saw the Peep Show, how Christian tried to instill some tough love into Edge, trying to motivate Edge towards Backlash. Christian knows Randy Orton extraordinarily well from many years ago here in WWE.
Then he should also know how much danger he's putting himself in this situation. That apprehension for a reason, gentlemen.
Look at you standing out here gloating, Randy. Huh? What kind of man are you? Huh? Well, according to you, you're the greatest wrestler ever. Legend killer. What I see, you're cold. You're calculating. And you're a son of a bitch. You think the redemption of Edge is over? You think his career is over? You're wrong. I've known Edge my entire life, and he's never quit. He's never quit, and he's not going to quit now. You don't get a say in how this story ends, Randy. When that time comes, Edge will get his closure on his terms. He'll get his closure on his terms, not yours. Do you understand me? He's coming back.
Is it okay if I cut you off now? I can't believe you come down this ramp blabbing and talking and interrupting me while I have such important things to say. This has never been about you. This story is about Edge and myself. It's not about you. It's never been about you. It never will be about you. You are nothing more than jealous of your friend Edge. But I see that look in your eye. I see that look. I know what you want. I'll tell you what you want. I know you better than you know yourself. You want one more match.
Absolutely not, Randy. Absolutely not. I'm out here to defend my friend.
Please, 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 to defend your friend. Come on, you and Edge, you're both the same. You can't accept the fact that this something you love more than anything in the world was taken away from you before you were ready to say goodbye. Now, I know you are not medically cleared to compete, but I got a way around that, you see. Tonight, Christian versus Orton, unsanctioned. What do you say? Just so you know, that offer expires by the end of the night. And if you don't accept, then it just proves what we all already know. That you're nothing more than a coward.
Randy Orton just challenged Christian to an unsanctioned match.
Considering...